The following is a semi-professional... Ah, fuck it, read it yourself. Alrighty, welcome back to Nihilhalla. We are today playing a game I recently acquired that is in early access, as you can see from the text that's superimposed real lightly at the top of the screen there.
You can see it better right there.
Yeah. This is Slime Rancher, which is, I don't know if anybody's, like, seen this game on Steam or, like, seen it in the store there. My initial thought when I first looked at it was like, oh, you just run around with a medic gun and vacuum up slimes. The game's a little more complex than that, I found.
I love the Capsule Corp diner in the background.
That's the house, actually.
Oh, okay. It looks like Capsule Corp stuff, though, you know?
Do you know why?
No.
The slime, as it was originally depicted in, I believe it was Dragon Quest?
Quest was the JRPG.
Yeah, the artist...
Oh, was that Dragon Warrior? No, it was Dragon Quest.
The artist who did the art for said game is also the artist for Dragon Ball Z.
Akira Toriyama?
Yep.
No way.
Yep, and that is why there's this Capsule Corp looking thing in the background, because if this is an official... Akira Toriyama, like, styling, like, these are the official slimes.
Oh, really?
Yeah, if they are the official slimes. I'm not saying they are, because they don't have the little pinched top.
To yeah, them. The little doop.
Yeah.
The little drop.
Immediately, this game is fun, right?
Yeah, it's immediately adorable.
Like, I watched, I watched the Game Grumps play it, and that's where I first, like... saw it for, like, actual gameplay, but I saw it on Steam long before they played it, and I was like, yeah. Oh my god, I have to try this. And then I saw them play it, and, like, they played it for a woefully short amount of time, and I was like, that's stupid.
I have a YouTube show. Yeah. I can play this game.
Yeah, for as long as I want, so fuck it. We're gonna play this. So we can sprint and do stuff like that. And one thing I noticed in my single-player playthrough, not this game doesn't have multiplayer, I should probably state that, but my own personal playthrough, let me put it that way.
Yeah.
Was I noticed that pink slimes are basically useless because they always exist in the wild out here. They literally jump out of the bushes sometimes. So your best bet is to start out with rock and tabby slimes if you want a lot of money.
Okay.
That is a Largo slime, which is just a big slime. So basically, the entire game is you try to farm up slimes, force feed them, and then harvest their shit.
Does it look adorable the entire time of force feeding?
Yeah, no, it's not like force feeding geese or anything that's like
awful.
Yeah, inhumane or anything like that. It's not like force feeding other animals. Although you are sort of vacuuming them up. In ow, fuck.
Oh, you have health. Oh shit.
Yeah.
So things can hurt you.
Oh yeah. And I think this.
So immediately, this game like looks adorable and fun. It kind of just like puts you right into it. No, what's this Snorlax?
This is the tabby Gordo, and if we feed him a chicken, he gets happy.
Oh.
Not as happy as if we feed him many chickens, of course, because he is a greedy slime. He's actually too big to move. All I think of whenever I look at the giant slimes, the Gordos, all I think of is Chubby Chocobo from the Chocobo games.
I don't know why Pokemon has programmed me to always see fat blobulous things in games as a fucking Snorlax.
I mean, I guess that's fair. It's definitely a fair comparison to make. I personally see my flat blobulous self as a Snorlax, perhaps. So
are you playing this game with, like, prior knowledge just to kind of show people the best way to go with it, or...?
I'm playing this... What is going on there?
Star?
Why is there that giant star there? I don't remember that before.
Well, I was going to show how super knowledgeable I was about this game, and then... Oh, it's just telling you to put your slimes in the slime bin.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
With your sweet tips.
I want the rock slimes in there. And we want to actually make this double height.
So they can't jump out?
Yeah, because they will jump out if given the opportunity. Alright, here you go, guys. There's... Oh, right. You gotta do that inside the cage. Ow. Dicks. Yeah. There you go, guys. There's some food.
Then I take it as you manage it up, like, different things want different diets and...
Oh, yeah. These guys are vegetarian. The pink slimes will eat anything. These guys are vegetarian, and the tabby slimes, which are the other ones here, these guys are carnivorous.
Exclusive. So really quick, on the left side, the 250 and the 10 and the 84
is
energy.
So this is my money here. Yeah. The 100 is my health, and then I've got a power meter, which is basically the amount of stamina I've got for
the day,
sprinting and things like that. No, it's just sprinting.
Okay.
And then later there's a jetpack upgrade I can get. although
that's why you saved the one carrot, so you could plant many carrots?
Yes. And now I've got to learn... I guess I've got to learn all this stuff. Again, because the game decided that I was defective. Look, I want your poop, not you guys. Get back in there.
So your gun lets you select what you shoot in and take in?
Yeah, well, sort of. What you vacuum up everything that's eligible for being vacuumed at the same time.
Okay.
But you can selectively eliminate, like, I just basically selected the Rocco slimes there.
Yeah.
Rock slimes, and sent them into the cage there. Which reminds me.
I kind of enjoy cutesy shit every once in a while. This game looks very cutesy.
It is. It absolutely is. I've got these tabby slimes, but I really don't have a place to put them right now.
Because you don't have a cage?
Yeah, I don't have a second pen set up, and I also kind of don't want one yet. because I need a hen house, and I need roosters so that I can make more baby chickens for the tabbies to eat.
So then how do you get more resources?
Well, the simple answer is to go to sleep for the night, wait for these guys to eat, and poop again.
So you can buy stuff?
Yep. Hey, look, another wild chicken. I'll take that.
For more plort.
Yes, slime plorts. Plort, 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 plort.
That is just adorable. So, what would you say this game is worth to what you paid for on Steam?
I paid $20 on Steam.
Okay.
And I paid it happily.
Yeah.
Now, I paid it with a gift card, so it wasn't technically my money, I guess, but at the same time...
Do you feel the $20 is worth, or so far?
Now that I've played it, I'd say it's easily worth 15.
Okay.
The game kind of holds your hand for a little bit longer than I'd like, but I'm pretty sure I can turn the tips off there.
Yeah. So on the American... Jesus, they like to kick your ass.
Yeah, they're trying. I'm trying to get all these plorts, though.
So I take it this is like part of the... oh no, they escaped.
Some of them did.
So I take it that's kind of like some of the harshness of the game is... You get hurt by powerful slimes as you try to collect stuff, and there's probably other ways to do that.
Ow, fucker. Stop that shit. Come here.
He is running.
Alright.
You lost a lot of slimes.
Yeah, there were 7 in there when I started, and I have 4 in my tube. So.
Oh, okay, now they're all back.
Yep. So we're good.
So on the American grading scale, what would you give this game, an A, B, C, D?
American grading scale?
Oh yeah, the very rough, hard American grading scale, the 7-point grading scale. Or we can do the 10-point grading scale to be easier, like 190 is an A, which is still a very harsh grading scale to the rest of the world, but it's an easy one to follow, because we have mostly American viewers.
Honestly, I'd give this game probably a B.
Okay.
B plus, maybe. I really haven't experienced much of the game, and it is still very unfinished.
Okay.
So I.
Oh, that's right. It still is beta.
Yeah, it's still very unfinished. It's technically speaking, it's a beta, but they're still adding a feature set to it, which, for those of you unfamiliar with software development, anything that's still adding feature set is still technically an alpha. So if you're playing, like, I don't know, an MMO or something like that, and you're like, oh man, like, this game is great, but they haven't finished it yet, and they're still adding features. That game is technically a beta, even though they're adding features, because it's, like, deployed. It's ready to go. You see what I mean about
the... Hey, fucker!
Yeah.
And I take it they just take up space in your gun, really. Oh, you can take their plort, though.
Yep, and their plort is worth money. So I am going to vacuum up all of the free plort.
I mean, would you say it's fair to just keep a full cage of slimes just to get their plort, or is their really plort just only worth it to pick up in the wild?
The pink guys feed themselves. They do not require domestication.
Because you see them in the wild and it's easy to exit them from your gun, you might as well just pick up their plort.
Exactly.
Is 20 looks like your main, because you only had 20 carrots and...
Yeah, 20 is the maximum number of...
For each box?
Yeah, for each individual slot of the gun.
Is that upgradable?
It is. I don't know what the new upgraded number is, though.
Ooh, what's the yellow plort on the ground? Is that a turkey?
It's a roostro, and I need one of those. Forgive me.
Oh, do the roostros fuck the hen hens and then make...
And then make...
more hen hens and roostros?
Actually, they make chickadoos.
Well, that's adorable. More on chickadoos on the next episode of Nihilhalla.